Hi guys, I'm Miss Lande, the lecturer for Entrepreneurship and Business Management N4, representing Obi TVET College from Mangwe Campus. Today we'll be doing the cash flow statement, which is part of your syllabus. We found that in chapter 8. Before we get into calculations, we need to understand why do we prepare the cash flow statement. Now, the cash flow statement indicates the movement of money into and out of the business. In the cash flow statement, we'll be recording only cash, hence the name cash flow statement. Now, this is the format for the cash flow statement. It does not change. It always stays like this. It starts with the balance at the beginning of the month and ends with the balance at the end of the month. In our cash flow statement, we record the receipts as well as the payments. Now, when we talk about the balance at the beginning of the month, the balance at the beginning of the month can either be favorable or unfavorable. The other term for favorable is debit. The other term for unfavorable is credit. Now, if they say the balance at the beginning of the month or at the end of the previous month, it is unfavorable. It means that we're going to put that amount in a bracket. Then we move to the receipts. Now, when we look at our receipts, we are looking at this part where we are going to cover the cash sales, the credit sales, other income, or other receipts. Now, firstly, let's look at the receipts. Our receipts are divided into two. Actually, the sales are divided into two, the cash sales as well as the credit sales. Our sales are always 100%. Now, they will tell you how much is our credit sales, how much is our cash sales. Sometimes they just give you the percentage for credit sales, so you have to calculate the credit sales. Now, let's say, for example, they said cash sales amounts to 75%. It means that you are going to say 100 less 75%, then our credit sales is going to be 25%. Same goes with the purchases, but I will explain more when we do the purchases. Now, in our cash receipts, we, as I mentioned, that we have the cash sales as well as the credit sales. It depends on the credit policy of the business as to how the customers or the debtors pays them the whatever that they have purchased on credit. Then we move to the second part of our cash flow statement, which is payments. Now, in our payments, we have monthly expenses, the cash purchases, credit purchases, as well as other payments. Now, we're going to treat cash purchases and credit purchases the same way we're going to deal with the cash sales. It depends on the percentage that they have provided. Now, at the end of our cash flow statement, we have what we call the balance at the end of the month. The balance can either be positive or negative. If it's negative, we're going to put it in brackets, and remember, it's going to be the opening balance for the coming month. Now we have the calculation that we are going to do. It's example 8.1 from your textbook. The projected cash flow statement, Joan Schoenfeld intends selling cosmetics in her area. Use the following information to draw up her projected cash flow statement to the next 3 months. At the end of January, she had a favorable balance of 4,500 rands. Use the answer sheet provided and copy it to your exercise book. Now, we are given months to calculate our cash flow statement. It starts with January, then we have February, as well as March and April. But you need to take note that the information said at the end of January, meaning that your cash flow statement will start in February. If they give you balance at the end of a certain month, it means that you must start at the following month. But if maybe they said the balance at the beginning of January is 4,500 rand, it means that our cash flow statement was going to start in January. We're given information. Normally we say these are the transactions. We don't necessarily say information given. Now we have about 6 transactions that took place. The first one, it says John will buy a car in February. The deposit will be 4,000 rands and the monthly payments thereafter 600 rands. Transaction number 2, in March, she will sell her old car for 5,000 rands cash. Number 3, her average monthly expenses are 3,600 rands. 4, 25% of Joanne's sales are on credit. This customer pays 30 days later. Now, you need to underline that. They say credit sales is 25%. Remember I said our sales are always 100%. Now, if they say credit sales are 25%, it means that the difference between 100 and 25 is 75, which is going to be our cash sales. And customers pay 30 days later, meaning that if they purchase in January, that 30 days later will be February. If they purchase in February, that 30 days will be March. Number 5, half of stock purchased are on credit. She pays 30 days later. Now, the owner of the business purchases some of the stock at half. Now, when they say half, it means that you need to check. We have 100% purchases. Now, half of 100% is 50%. This simply means that 50% will be on credit and 50% will be on cash. Then the last transaction, she will pay 400 rands for rates and taxes in March. Now we are going to start our cash flow statement calculations. The first part, remember I said, is this, the balance at the beginning of the month. Now when we check the information provided, it said that at the end of January, they had a favorable bank balance of 4,500 rands. So we are going to record it under February as 4,500 rands. Now it is favorable, we are not going to put it in brackets, but if it was unfavorable, we are going to put it in brackets. Before we can calculate the cash sales, we need to check how much was our estimated sales for the month of February, because our cash flow statements starts with February. Now we go back to the table that is provided. We check our February estimated sales is 6,000 rands. Remember they said 25% of sales is on credit and then cash is going to be 75%. How do we calculate the cash sales? We go back, we say 6,000 rands multiplied by 75%, or you can say 6, if your calculator does not have the percentage sign, 6,000 multiplied by 75 divided by 100, then you will get your amount, which is 4,500 rands. We are done with the cash sales. We have to calculate the credit sales for the month of February. Now, here is what makes students confused. Remember they said customers pays 30 days later, meaning that whatever that was bought in January is going to be paid in February. So we need to go back to the previous month of January to check how much was our estimated sales so that we can calculate the 25% that is to be paid in February. So when we check our transactions there, it says 10,000 rand was for our estimated sales. We multiply it by 25%, then we get 2,500 rands. We are done with the sales, both credit and cash, for the month of February. Now we need to check if maybe in our transactions there is other income, the income that they received in the business, which is not related to whatever that they are selling. But now when we check in our transaction, the information that is provided, it talks about March, not February. So if there is no transaction that took place in February, which must be recorded under other income or receipts, we simply put a dash, not a zero. Now, this brings us to the end of our cash receipts. We need to calculate how much is our total cash available. We have 4,500 as our opening balance, plus our cash sales of 4,500, plus our credit sales, which is 2,500. Then the total is 11,500 rands. Now this total, we call it total cash available. It's the cash that the business is expecting for the month of February. Then we move to monthly expenses. Now our monthly expenses remains constant. If maybe they say monthly expenses is 3,000 rand, it means that for the preparation or for the months that you are preparing the cash flow statement, it will remain that amount. Now, when we look at our transactions, the average monthly expenses is 3,600. Please allow me to write 3,600 to the last month so that we don't forget. So we covered the monthly expenses, the amount is given. Sometimes they don't give you the total amount. They give you transactions like salaries, wages, rent, electricity, telephone. So if they're giving you individual accounts, you need to add those amounts, then may come up with a total. So we have to calculate the cash purchases, meaning that we need to move to the third column of the information provided. Now remember, there's a transaction that talks about the purchases. It says half of her stock purchases are on credit, meaning that the first cash sales will be 50%, the second part will be 50%. Now how much is our cash purchases in February? It's 60,000 rand. Now 60,000, is it 60? Yes, not 60, sorry, it's 6,000 rand. 6,000 rand multiplied by 50%. Remember, we are calculating the cash purchases. It's going to give us 3,000 rand. Then our credit purchases, they said half of the stock is on credit. So it means that it 50% also applies in the credit. Now remember, when we are calculating the sales, I said, if they say customers pay 30 days later, it means that they need to go back to the previous month. Now in this case, the owner of the business purchased some stock in January and that amount is going to be paid the following month, which is February. So we need to go back to the previous month, which is January, and check how much is 50% of the purchases for January. We find that the purchases for January was 5,000 rands. So half of 5,000 rand is 2,500 rands. Once we have dealt with the purchases, it's now we can treat other payments. Now, other payments, we record transactions like deposit, other expenses that were not covered during the calculation of the monthly expenses. Now, when we check our cash flow statement, do we have other payments for the month of February? Yes, transaction number one. It says Joel will buy a car in February. The deposit will be 4,000 rand and the monthly payments after is going to be 600 rand. Now we are going to record that 4,000 under other payments. It does not form part of our monthly expenses because it is a deposit. So we have a amount of 4,000 rand for other payments in February. After dealing with the cash payments, we need to calculate the balance at the end of the month. Now, I just realized that there's a slight mistake that I made. I was supposed to add the cash payments. My apologies, guys. It's total payments, actually. Then after total payments, we have the balance at the end of the month. Now, how do we calculate our total payments? We are going to add from the monthly expenses until the other payments. So our monthly expenses is 3,600 plus cash purchases of 3,000 rand plus credit purchases of 2,500 rand plus other payments of 4,000 rand. Now our total payment is 13,100 rand. Now, before we can calculate the balance at the end of the month, we need to check how much is the cash that we are expecting as the business. And when we check, we realize that the cash that we are going to receive in February, it's less than what we are going to spend, which is our payments. Now, when we calculate, we don't say, no, our payments are more than our cash available, therefore 13,100 subtract 11,500. It is total cash available less total payments. Now our total cash available, remember I said it's 11,500 less 13,100. Then it gives us a negative amount of 1,600 rand. Now, remember I said, if the balance is negative, it means that it is unfavorable. Now, when it is unfavorable, we put it in brackets. Our balance at the end of the month is going to be our opening balance for the coming month, meaning that the balance at the end of February is going to be the opening balance for March. We take it as it is with that bracket. Then we have to go back to our sales to calculate our cash sales, our credit sales, check if there are other income, then calculate the total cash available. Now, when we look at the information given, remember we are dealing with March, meaning that you need to go back to March. Our estimated sales for March is 8,000 rand. So it's going to be 8,000 multiplied by 75%. Remember, we said cash sales, it's 75%. Then it gives us 6,000 rand. Then we move to credit sales. Our credit sales is 25%. We go back to the previous month, which is February. We say 6,000 rand multiplied by 25%. Then we get 1,500 rand. Now we come to other income or receipts. We check if maybe we have received a certain amount, even if it's not related to what the business is rendering. Now we find that transaction number two says in March, she will sell her old car for 5,000 rands. So this 5,000 rands, we are going to record it under other income or receipts. Then we are done with the part of the receipts we need to calculate. Now, students always make a mistake when they calculate a total cash available if an amount is negative. Now, I normally advise students to press the negative sign button on the calculator. For example, plus or minus, that button of plus or minus, you press it first, then you say 1,600 plus 6,000 rand plus 1,500 plus that 5,000 rand. Then it gives us 10,900. It is our total cash available. We've dealt with the monthly expenses. We are just going to go to the cash purchases. Remember the policy of the business. It says that 50% is on cash, 50% is on credit. Now we check, we are dealing with March. How much was our estimated purchases? It was 8,000 rand. So it's very simple, 8,000, half of it is 4,000 rand. Then we check the credit purchases. Remember, we go to the previous month. The previous month is February. Our expected purchases was 6,000, half of 6,000 is 3,000 rand. Then we have to check if maybe there are other payments. Remember transaction number one said in February, the owner of the business will deposit a car for 4,000 rands. And then the monthly payments thereafter will be 600 rands. Meaning that each and every month they will be paying 600 rands for installment of that car. But it does not end there when we talk about other payments. Transaction number six says she will pay 400 rands for rates and taxes in March. So we're going to take that 600 rand, which is the installment of the car, plus 400 rand for rates and taxes. That amounts to 1,000 rand. Then after that, we calculate the total payments. We're having 3,600 rand plus 4,000 rand plus 3,000 rand plus 1,000 rand. The total is 11,600. We have to calculate the balance at the end. Remember to calculate that we say total cash available less total payments. Then you will get the balance at the end of the month. Now, our total cash available is 10,900 less 11,600. Then we have negative 700 rands. Now, when is a negative, remember, we put it in a bracket. The balance at the end of the current month will be the opening balance of the next month. So we take that 700 as it is. We are done with that part. We have to calculate the cash sales. Remember, 75% is on cash, credit is 25%. We go back to the table given. We check, we are dealing with April. Our estimated sales is 7,000 rands. So we are going to say 7,000 multiply by 75%. We get 5,250. Then our credit sales, remember we go to the previous month, which is March. Our sales for March was 8,000 rand. We calculate 25% of 8,000, which gives us 2,000 rand. Do we have other income? As per information provided, we don't have other income. Therefore, we simply put a dash and we do calculation for our total cash available, which is negative 700 plus 5,250 plus 2,000 rand. Then we have positive 6,550. It is our total cash available. We already dealt with monthly expenses. Now we need to calculate the cash purchases. Very simple because it says half, meaning 50-50. Now for April, our cash purchases amounts to 7,000. Half of 7,000 is 3,500. Then our credit purchases. We go back to the previous month, which is March. Half of our 8,000 is 5,000 rands. Not 500, sorry, 4,000 rands. Then other payments. Remember, there is that installment that is continuing for the vehicle or the car that was purchased in February. Now, there's no other information that talks to April, meaning that we are only going to record that 600 rands. Then we do our calculations for our total payments. We have 6,550 plus 3,600 plus 3,500 plus 4,000. There's a mistake that I made, but let's correct it quickly. Remember, we're working with numbers. Sometimes it's not easy. It's actually monthly expenses of 3,600 rand plus 3,500 for cash purchases plus credit purchases of 4,000 rands plus 600 rands. Then the total is 11,700 rands. It is a positive amount, obviously. Then we need to calculate the balance at the end of the month. Now we are going to say total cash available, which is 6,550 less 11,700. Then it gives us a negative 5,150. Now, looking at our cash flow statement, when we analyze it, it indicates that this business needs to obtain a loan, because from February to the last month of our cash flow statement, they're always running with a negative amount. So it means that they will always run short. Now, to avoid that, they need to obtain a loan from the bank. And one of the things that you need to be careful of, you need to check your calculations, because now if you make a mistake, let's say in our credit sales, your calculation is incorrect, it is going to affect your total cash available, your balance at the end of the month. Remember, this balance, we transfer it to the next month. So everything that follows will be incorrect. Thank you guys for watching. I hope that you will do more exercises from your textbooks.